Hello everyone, today we have new video review and as you can see this time we are going to check fresh release from Edward. This is a big ad collection set, so as you can see there are several sets inside this big cardboard envelope. And we have a commercial sample, so it means you will get exactly the same stuff as what you'll see in this video. So, first of all, this particular release is designed for use with EF16C Block 25 in 1/48 scale, so it means for Tamiya kit, and I can zoom in so that you can see what we actually get here inside. So there are removed before flight steel flex, also a PE set for the external detailing, also steel belts, and of course mask set. As far as you can see, it is designated under EX product number. So overall package and style is typical. We have a commercial sample, so it means you will get exactly the same stuff. And now we are going to open it and check what is actually supplied here. So just give me a second to cut through this tape, because it is usually sealed with such high-tech tool, sticky tape. So just give me a second. It's a very sharp knife. I mean, I'm really surprised with how sharp it stays over the time. I've been using it for several years already and it's still sharp, really. I wouldn't say it on the camera, but it's really sharp. I hope you get it. So here we open it and remove all the sets outside. Here they are, and that's pretty much all. Okay, so what do we have here? We have masks, we have the steel belts, we have PE set, and we have the remove before flight flex. I would like to start with masks, because it is interesting to see what will be actually covered with these masks. And as you remember, 1/48 scale kits from Tamiya, they usually include masks, but they are not pre-cut. Edward masks are pre-cut, so it means easier to use, and of course they are ready to be used straight away out of the package. For example, if I zoom in here, now you should be able to see at least barely that we have here some cuts, and I can see masks for wheels here, so I think it will be shown on the application manual. So let's open it. Here it is. And here you can check what we actually have on the application manual. So as I said, we have masks for wheels, we have masks for the canopy, and note that you have to use liquid mask, but it is typical for such type of the canopy as on the F16, so there is no surprise in this. And on the opposite side, we have also some application mask guide. So just give me a second. Oh, so you can mask it actually from both sides, from inside and from outside. That's really cool, because Tamiya does not provide such thing. They provide only external masks. Next, we go on with this small set. So this is a steel belt for F16. Just give me a second to open it. So why steel belts? They are usually thinner than typical Edward PE, and they admit it openly, so they are easier to manipulate on the model, and they are more natural looking addition to your aircraft set in comparison with typical PE parts. It's not to say that PE parts are really bad, but steel belts are thinner and they look more natural in comparison with PE parts. So here you can see the steel belts, they are pre-painted, they are color printed, and here you can see the thickness. They're really thin, almost like a tin foil, so in some cases you have to be careful in order not to break them or damage them, because otherwise it will be almost impossible to fix them. And next we have the installation guide, which should be quite easy. Here it is. Let's zoom out. Now you should be able to see what we have to do. So basically you install all the belts on the standard seat. You have to delete this plastic, because it will be replaced with these steel belts, but that's pretty much all you have to do. And overall installation process should be straightforward, especially if you are brave enough to work with 1/48 F16. Okay. Next, we go on with this set. This one is more a universal set, because, I mean, remove before flight flags, they can be used almost on any NATO aircraft in 1/48 scale. So here we get them made as a steel product again. So as you can see, they're really thin. And just give me a second. So So let's zoom in. Now you should be able to see them. So of course they are color printed. Here you can see them from both sides. And they're again really thin, so you can see that they slightly bent during shipment, but that's not a serious problem. Next we go on with application manual. So this one is quite straightforward. I mean, just apply the flex and you'll be good to go, but you have to use your own wire. Wire is not supplied in this set. Okay. And last but not the least is this PE set. It is designed for external and internal detailing, as far as you can see. So let's open it and check what is actually included here. So first of all, we have color printed PE fret, and then we have this traditional golden color fret as well. And then we also have the assembly manual or application manual in the middle. Here it is. So first of all, let me show you the frets, and then we'll check the stuff here. So first of all, we get the gloss finish on the dials, which is really cool. It will be more realistic appearance on the finished model, and it's really important in 1/48 scale, so don't underestimate it. And here we have the golden PE fret. This one will be handy for both external and internal elements. This is typical Edward product, so no surprises here, I would say, and it should be relatively easy to work with. And next we go on with application manual, which is full with red color, and I hope you understand what it means. You have to modify original plastic parts, for example cockpit elements for sure. Here we continue with the homing panel. Again, some parts replaced with PE parts. For example, here you can see on the pilot seat you have to replace some PE parts. I mean, also cut off the standard plastic and replace it with PE parts. So be ready for this. Do it before application of steel belts, because otherwise it will be really tricky to think to do. Next, we continue with the side panels. Here we have side vents. And if we flip over this application manual, here you can see that we also modify, for example, the engine nozzle. It will be modified with PE parts, which is really funny. Next we continue with canopy here, canopy railings, also some air intakes as far as you can see, antennas on the ailerons, and that's pretty much all. So as I said, this set overall big ad collection is available on official Edward website, and if you would like to save some money and use some upgrades on your F-16, this should be a more budget conscious purchase, especially if you consider getting all of these sets. So of course I will be happy to hear your opinion about this set here in the comment section below. If you like this video, don't forget to press the like button, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I will see you in the next video review as usual. Thank you for watching and bye.